Very good. Very good. The mayor of Cambridge. Stephen Coleman.
Good morning, ma'am.
Jason made the white for the constitution. And one of my secretaries, Sam Basovich, who is the chief constable. And chief executive is the mayor of the welcome. So I'd first like to introduce Mr. David Page, who is my colleague who is in charge of all of the building projects.
This has been quite a lot of
projects. Yes, the two new buildings here, one on our main side. I've been busy.
And so Kathleen Abbott and Lawrence Weaver. So these are the grandchildren of our founder, Lawrence Weaver.
Really?
Yes. I hope that later we'll be able to reproduce the picture that was taken at the planting of the tree by Queen Mary.
You still keep an interest.
Yes.
Mr. James Godfrey is the chairman of our board. And Mr. Jeremy Lewis is the chairman of the
trust.
The
trust.
Yes.
Trust.
Yes. Which is in the and Mr. Kelly Preston, who was a member of our board and trust and chaired both the board and the trust, who's been with NIAB over all the changes that we have had over the last few years.
And this is a demonstration of how people with rights support breeding and innovation of new varieties. So the scheme means that breeders can claim a royalty on each plant that they sell, and that can be reinvested in breeding programs. And these are examples of companies within the UK where breeding has developed these beautiful new varieties supported by native South African plants that British enthusiasts collected seed from and hybridised. Yes. So these are
quite long.
So we're going to go into the spectrum. We'll have our work on cereals. So Claire Carpenter will tell you a little bit about that.
I'm looking at the seed certification thing. Can we provide consumer protection for farmers to make sure that every bag of cereal they buy is true to type? It falls as it should on its top leg making weeds. They want to make sure that they won't have it turned away when it gets to the mill at the other end of their growing chain.
It's about the Second World War, and now once we join the EU, it becomes a statutory requirement to keep it going, really. So it means that we trade grain all over the world as a country, and every country that imports our grain knows that it is of a specific quality. We have those varieties in the British salt industry, and also varieties. And so we worked with the companies who managed it, and we trained them how to purify their own stocks. And still back today, it's now in the top 5% of malting bottles in the
And in fact, here you're talking to Hillary, whom we spoke to with the flowers over there. Yes. A couple of photos from your show plots, and yourself on 81. So this is our timeline, and it's quite long, but we've taken over the country this year, goes quite to that end.
So this is where it started?
Yes, 1919, yes. Last we were at our houses. And we combined all the information from this timeline. So I think,
in the long line.
Every 10 years we chose events which were important to UK agriculture. So this is the signature of King George V of Queen Mary, who came over here. And then more recently, the Duke of Cambridge came here on a private visit and was doing his course on
And you can see we only have a biro between us. We know it's such a nice pen as well. We wondered if you'd be happy to sign. And here's a bowl made by Lawrence Weaver's granddaughter out of the wood of that same tree.
Oh.
So we'd like to give you that to take.
That's very kind, isn't it?
Really nice. It's very, very
what,
simple.
What was the tree?
It was a mulberry. A mulberry tree.
So what we're trying to do here is to reinvent wheat. So wheat appeared in the Middle East. This is modern pasta wheat, but a wild relative of that. And one third came from this wild beast, which we call goat grass. And it's the genes from the goat grass that we think have made wheat such a successful crop. It's grown from Scandinavia and Canada all the way down to Chile. It's one of the most adaptable crops that there is, but it has some horrible characteristics of drops in seeds. Happens when we make a new cross. So we will turn this plant into a female, we'll introduce pollen from the goat grass, and we get something like this, which is what we think some of the first primitive weeds were like. And again, these are horrible. If you were to try and scrub out the grains, they would hurt your hand.
Mm-hmm.
So what we then do is make a cross with a modern variety. So this is an English spring wheat called Carrigan, and a winter wheat called Robidus. And we make a cross between our rewilded wheat and this work to find interesting genes for disease resistance and hopefully for drought resistance, tolerance, and this sort of thing. But we've actually introduced useful variations for yield as well. So these are some of the babies of this cross, when we stabilise them, and very quickly we're able to go to a nice high yielding type. We know that some of these have good disease resistance.
Is it bigger than that?
Yes, there are more heads of each plant as well. So when we get to a decent quantity of seed, we take them out to the field and we'll grow them like a farmer's crop, but in 15% by introducing these lost genes from the wild relatives.
I don't think it's well understood. I think farmers have to be very broadly knowledgeable.
So, James Godfrey, our chairman, is here with Spade. If you'd like to, we'll give you the option of doing yourself, or he will.
No, thank you for that.
Excellent, thank you.
Do you want to come round in picture? I think you'd better come further round. So grandchildren are founders.
He's your grandfather.
I gather it died.
Died
the tree.
No, the tree.
Oh, yes.
But the bowl was made by my sister out of a piece of the tree.
It was very kind of it. And it was a
mulberry.
Mulberry,
yes. She's a lovely wood. Yeah.
And you did the turning yourself, didn't you?
Yes.
That's very
nice.
I'm
very grateful.
Yes. Well, something's going to
have
to plant it properly now.
Yes, I'll
that's James'
This is a hornbeam.
It's a hornbeam. Yes, and they're nice shapes, aren't they?
Yes.
You've got an avenue.
Happy with the blue hat. managed to introduce you to some of our members who have contributed to the building and organization of the hospital. We've chosen people who've given a lot of their own time to come to help us and everything to be ready for our patients.
So what do you do?
I'm an anesthetist and a intensivist. And I helped all the IT equipment in the
anesthesia. Okay.
It is very technical and a lot of machines usually.
I'm sure, yes.
That we've taken away from the room, so we have plenty of space to greet you.
Yes, I'm one of the ODPs. I work in theatre.
My name's Natasha, and my sister's here at Critical Care, and so Julie and the rest of the team helped with the relocation.
It was a lot of planning, and a lot of work, but everyone was.
He's going to try and turn right.
So how are you getting on?
Brilliant. If it wasn't for this man, I don't think I'd have the energy I've got. It was a good operation. When I came here, I couldn't hardly breathe.
Really?
Yeah, and now I can, well, not run, but I can get around and move well. I hope to go back to work, you know, and start being a man again.
Well, that's splendid, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, yes. It's made me happy again, so.
So he's one of the first patients, really, here, isn't he?
He is one of the first patients, and he's done
marvellously
well.
Just to give everyone the opportunity to come over.
Can you look to me for a second here, too? Thank you. That's all right. Yeah.
And I would like to introduce two of our very special and brave young ladies who have both been patients of ours, Yasmin and Eliza. They both spent quite a while in Patford Hospital, actually waiting for a life-saving organ transplant. And Yasmin was lucky to have a double lung transplant, and Eliza a heart transplant shortly afterwards.
Very fortunate, weren't they?
We were really lucky.
Very lucky.
It was only in the end of January, start of February, so Yasmin came in. We came in at the same time. Yasmin had a lung transplant the same day that we came in, so we only had a couple of hours together, but like, those couple of hours were amazing because we just got on so well. Mm. We had so much in common, like just tiredness and like bad hearts, bad lungs. And then the day that Yasmin left, which was a month later, I had my heart transplant. Mm-hmm. So you were literally leaving, weren't you? And the coordinator came to me and was like, you're about to have your heart transplant. So the stars kind of aligned. And now we're here.
You might not be able to believe it, looking at them so well at the moment, you know, they were really at death's door. And they were absolutely.
So you now can do almost anything, can you? You can almost do anything now. With
yeah, really, just I'm doing a lot of yoga at the moment, lots of walks with my mum.
Mm-hmm.
Just, yeah, it's really great.
And you can do things now which you couldn't do before.
Yeah, so I'm trying to do a bit of yoga as well. I'd really like to start horse riding again because I had to stop because my heart condition and falling off horses and things wasn't the best thing. I'd like to start surfing again because I live in Penzance. So quite far away.
Quite far away, isn't it? Yeah. It's very nice.
Very
nice to see you again.
Thank you.
Lovely to see you.
Yeah, it's great. Thank you.
Great honour for us to have your visit.
Are you going
to
give the flowers?
What shall I get this?
I've got those flowers. Yeah. Thank you.
How lovely. Thank you. Thank you.
It's a privilege and honour to have Your Majesty and Your Royal Highness to visit our magnificent new hospital here at Papworth and to meet staff and patients. The move to the biomedical campus has been long in the planning, but thanks to the efforts of many people, some of them here, this has now been successfully completed. The main reason for our move were to be closer to the clinical college at Adam Brookes Hospital, the medical school and other departments of the University of Cambridge. Part of the wider campus. As part of the continued development, we hope very soon to be able to construct the new Heart and Lung Research and Education Institute, which is conjoined to our hospital. This will further enhance the understanding of heart and lung disease, better to develop treatments for our patients here and around the world. But as you've just seen, the movie's not just about the buildings, however impressive they are, it's about the people in them. All of the people who work here. The culture of our hospital has been built over many years in the old hospital and has been sustained and successfully transplanted into our new home. Our journey to the new hospital has been both challenging and complex and has required remarkable. Now we're here, we're working together for the benefits that this hospital will realise. I remember a time some many years ago when Your Majesty formally opened one part of the hospital. There we go.
did make you some flowers and a card, but they've already put it in the back of your car.
Oh, okay.
Because we didn't know if we could meet you. Had a very busy morning, haven't we? Doing lots. We were so excited to come and see you. Haven't we? Thank you so much.